Hi Brolies, Marvin here from techbrawl.com, where we do unboxings, reviews, and sexy b-rolls. And today, I'll finally share with you my lighting setup for my live streams and unboxings as I get a lot of questions about it. In this video, I'll feature a couple of lighting equipment from Unbeatful, the Unbeatful FL80 video light, and the Unbeatful A1 portable LED light. And for my overhead lighting setup, I'll feature the Yeelight Screen Light Bar Pro from Bangoo.com. With that being said, let's get into it. Alright guys, let's start with the unboxing experience and setup of our first lighting equipment, which is the Unbeatful FL80 video light. Unbeatful sent this over alongside the A1 portable video light, which you can check out on their Amazon store. My review sample came with this bag, and inside it we have all the package contents needed to set this up. However, at least for what they sent me, it didn't come with a light stand, so I had to purchase one myself. Alright, so inside the bag we have the instruction manual with easy to understand illustrations written in both English and Chinese. We also have the power adapter, an adapter plug, a cold shoe mount, a honeycomb grid that can be attached via Velcro strap, a removable softbox, a standard Bowens mount reflector diffuser lampshade, a 60-inch Bowens mount parabolic softbox, and the 80W Unbeatful FL80 LED video light itself. At first look and touch, the build quality feels good with aluminum construction. Flipping it on this side, we have the single LED that features 5600K color temperature with a CRI or color rendering index of 96+. Again, this Bowens mount compatible with a nice red accent locking mechanism right here. Now, here on the top side, we have some ventilation, and inside the components, it looks like we have a heatsink and a cooling fan. Now, the good thing about this compared to other video lights is that the locking mechanism for the tilt adjustment is made out of metal, which means not only it can support its own weight, but it also can support a handful of heavy Bowens mount accessories. Underneath here, we have another ventilation, and we also have a better view of the fan inside. This fan is actually relatively quiet, which is vital for on-cam video recordings. Now, you can mount the Unbeatful FL80 on any standard light stand, wall mount, or ceiling mount. And lastly, we have our control unit here at the back, which I will show you how to operate later. But essentially, we have a display right here, a DC in power port, a power button, an adjustment knob that also doubles as a button, and we also have the channel and group button, trigger lock to keep your settings safe, and the effects and CCT button. Alright, so with the unboxing of the Unbeatful FL80 video light out of the way, let's set this up real quick. The first thing that we have to do is to prepare the 60-inch parabolic softbox by stretching these metal rods right here until they lock in place. You may have to exert some force, but don't worry about it breaking as it is quite flexible. Once done, you can secure the softbox by strapping it together using the Velcro straps. Next, install the included softbox diffuser by strapping it as well using the built-in Velcro straps. And that's about it. We now have our foldable and portable parabolic softbox right here. Now, depending on your use case scenario and setup, you can mount this on the ceiling using a ceiling mount like this, or just mount it traditionally on a movable light stand like this. I prefer the latter for better flexibility. Now, as you can see here, I was using this tiny ring light and LED bulb combination, which is fairly decent but not as ideal as a proper video light like the Unbeatful FL80, so it's really nice that I'm now able to upgrade from this. Mounting the Unbeatful FL80 is pretty straightforward. Just secure the video light on the light stand, remove the Bowens mount adapter so that it is easier to install on the FL80 as you can see here, and then install the 60-inch parabolic softbox like so. Next, plug the power adapter and voila! We're done with the first lighting equipment on our setup. Okay, so next, let's unbox the second lighting gear on our setup, which is the Unbeatful A1 portable video light. Now, I don't usually use this for live streaming, but I often use this for my standard unboxings and reviews, especially for B-rolls and macro shots wherein more focused light is necessary. Inside the box, we have the user manual with illustrations as well. We also have a warranty card and the Unbeatful A1 portable LED light. Underneath the packaging, we have more items. We have this nice and soft pouch, we have a cold shoe mount, a USB Type-C charging cable, and a silicone diffuser right here. At first look and touch, the Unbeatful A1 feels really solid and hefty, and you can really feel the amazing build quality of this tiny portable LED light. Here we have a small display which is very handy, then we have our adjustment buttons here on the side. And then here we have the built-in adjustable mounting arm. Even this arm is solidly built as well, made out of aluminum. Again, we have our buttons here on the side. And then here we have the quarter-inch thread and the USB Type-C port for charging. On the other side, we have the power switch. Now, the Unbeatful A1 features 360 degrees full color mode, with built-in lighting effects and color temperature ranging from 2500 to 8500K. It also has its own app, which we're going to take a look at in a minute. Now, what's good about this is that even without the application, the controls are pretty intuitive, and the LED display certainly helps with accurately adjusting the settings. You can adjust the color hue, brightness, and saturation on the color mode, choose between the different built-in lighting effects, set up the CCT color temperature and brightness, and a lot more. But with the application, it makes the job even easier with just a few taps on your smartphone. Everything is laid out pretty well on the app, and the adjustment is almost instantly without any perceivable latency. Now, before we move on to our third and last equipment, let me just share with you a quick brightness level test for the Unbeatful FL80 and A1 so that you can have a bit of an idea of how capable they are. However, I apologize in advance if I can provide you with a better and accurate representation of their brightness quality, as I don't have a proper tool yet. But what I can say is that the Unbeatful FL80 is powerful enough to light a small room, and usually, when I use it as my key light for my on-cam recordings and live streaming, I'm just using around 50% brightness. That's how powerful it is for lighting a subject a few feet away. This is good for on-cam recordings and B-rolls. Of course, if you need to light up an entire room with multiple subjects, you may need to bump up the brightness up to 80 to 100%. The same goes for the Unbeatful A1, and I would say, for the majority of my use case scenarios and subjects, especially for B-rolls and macro shots, the brightness level of the Unbeatful A1 is more than sufficient. Now, one last thing before we move on, let me just show you the available settings for the Unbeatful FL80, since I really want to share with you all the information I can provide, even if this is not a full review. So again, we have our display right here, where we have the color temperature, the actual temperature of the device, the channel and group settings, the brightness levels, and the current mode, which in this case is CCT. Again, we have the channel group, which in a way is kinda useless at this point, since the variant that I have here doesn't have a remote or application. Here we have the trigger lock, so that you won't accidentally change your settings. And then here we have the adjustment knob for the brightness levels, and here we have the effects button, which includes lighting, TV, and more effects. And you can also adjust these effects using this knob as well. And lastly, we have the CCT button to go back to the standard video light mode. Alright guys, for the third and last lighting equipment that I use on my live streaming and overhead unboxings, we have the Yeelight Screen Light Bar Pro from Bango.com. I've been using this even before I had the Unbeatful lighting gears, and now I would say the combination of these three pieces of equipment really improved my lighting setup. Upon opening the box, the first thing that I picked up is the adjustment knob right here that feels really nice with a smooth rotation for adjusting the brightness levels. This is wireless and automatically communicates with the light bar without any pairing setup whatsoever. Now here at the bottom, we have the battery compartment, which requires two AAA batteries that thankfully are included in the package. Next, we have this quite hefty mounting accessory that you need to be able to mount the light bar on a monitor. It snaps right into the bezel of a monitor, providing that the bezel is within the supported thickness. We also have a couple of power pins here, and the light bar actually attaches here magnetically. Right here at the back, we have the USB Type-C power port, and we also have a substantial amount of rubber pads to keep this thing in place once mounted. Next, we have a quick setup guide that unfortunately is only written in Chinese. Same with the user manual right here. Next, inside this small accessory box, we have the USB Type-C power adapter. And lastly, we have the Yeelight Screen Light Bar Pro, which features a dual light source design. The first one is the main light source, and the second one is the RGB ambient backlighting that you can also integrate with Razer Chroma if you're into that. Overall, the build quality is pretty solid, and I'm sure about that because I've already dropped this a couple of times and it still works properly. Again, it snaps in magnetically and satisfyingly on the monitor mount like so. Now, my setup is quite unorthodox to be honest, since the bezel of my ultra-wide monitor is quite thick. I had to remove the heavy part of the mounting accessory and just YOLO it by securing it with heavy-duty zip ties on my overhead camera mount, as you can see here. Now, it may look stupid, but it works perfectly for my setup, since the light bar itself is extended towards my desk and right below my overhead camera, which gives my subject that balanced lighting. And not only that, I can easily adjust the brightness levels on the fly using this wireless knob, which proved to be quite vital depending on my subject. Of course, combining this with the Unbeatful FL80 video light, I have all the lighting I need for any type of subject, whether I'm shooting on-cam recordings, live streaming with dual camera setup, or just simply shooting some dedicated unboxings and reviews. And if ever I need more light or light that I can focus on a particular close-up shot, I can easily grab the Unbeatful A1 as you can see here. This is useful for shooting macro shots wherein I need to focus a significant amount of light closely on my subject, and if necessary, I can also mount this on a tripod so that I can balance out my lighting with having two lights, one on the left and one on the right. Alright guys, so to conclude, if you're planning on setting up a decent lighting setup for your live streams, you don't necessarily need to copy what I have here because obviously, different shooting setups require a unique combination of equipment. This is just me sharing with you what I have and maybe get some idea for your own lighting setup. This by far is not the best or perfect setup, but for what it is, I'm extremely happy and satisfied with it. And my livestream viewers can probably attest to that as they often appreciate the quality of my lighting, which I am very thankful for. And there you have it guys, thank you for watching. Huge thanks to Unbeatful and Bangoo.com for sending this equipment in. You can get this using the links below. Oh, by the way, I'm planning on making an updated setup tour video soon, so make sure to subscribe so you won't miss out. Thank you for watching, have a great day guys, you're awesome.